A lot of you are familiar with two products that you see at quilt shops, Retain and Centripol, and are often confused by what each of them does and when you would use it. So I thought this would be a great chance to clear that up and walk you through each of them. And to do that, I'm going to start with a couple of quilts. Right behind me, I have Glyphs, which is in issue 9 of our magazine. This is a really wonderful quilt that uses improvisational piecing, and we used all hand-dyed fabrics for this. And if you've ever used the kind of beautiful suede look hand dyes, you know that they're alluring, they're beautiful color, but many of them bleed like crazy. So it's really, really important not just to pre-wash them, but often to pre-treat them. So I've got a whole bunch of cuts of different hand dyes here, and you'll notice they're all frayed. The reason is we bought small pieces, but even though they're small, we put them in a lingerie bag and we pre-washed them. But we didn't just pre-wash them. We used Centripol and Retain at different points in the process. So this is where I'll explain the difference. So Centripol is what's called a surfactant. Its job is to wash away any excess dye that happens to be on fabric. So let's say you have a whole bunch of purple hand dyes, or you have purple batiks, or, and I have examples here of other fabrics this applies to, batiks, hand-printed fabrics. Often when they're imported, you don't know what the process was, and these dyes might not be stable. So whether they're batiks or hand dyes or hand-printed, this all applies. What we do is we get like colors together. So we'll gather all, say, our blues and purples that we're afraid might bleed. We put them in a separate small load, and we add, you have a choice here. You can add Centripol, and what that does is when they're washed, if there's any extra dye, it basically encapsulates that dye and flushes it out with the discharge water. So the idea is you're trying to get the extra dye, encapsulate it, and flush it out. However, if there's too much dye, let's say you put a color catcher in and it comes in really dark, the other approach is to take all your light colors to begin with and add Retain. Retain is a fixative, and what it does is it bonds the dye to the fabric. So if you're ever using Retain, you want to be really, really careful just to use it with light colors. Because let's say I put a bunch of these dark purples in to pre-wash them, and I take a lighter pink batik and I put them in the same load and I put Retain in. Well, what'll happen? If these bleed onto that, it will fix it in place, and you're never getting that out. However, if I put Retain with these and a little bit of one purple bleeds onto another, you probably won't see it and it would be fine. The other reason to really, really understand the difference between Centripol and Retain is if you're washing a quilt and you're afraid that it might bleed, do not use Retain, because what that would do is it would permanently fix any bleeding that occurred. Instead, you're gonna add a little Centripol, following the directions on the label, add a little Centripol to your wash, so if anything does bleed, it encapsulates that dye and flushes it out. So in the case of the Glyphs quilt, we pre-washed over and over till our, pre-washed, and we actually used Centripol and Retain at different times until our color catchers came out relatively clean. But because, you know, water, municipal water can change slightly from day to day or temperatures change, we still didn't totally trust it, which is another reason we use this kind of mushroom colored field fabric so that if any of these did bleed a tiny bit, it wouldn't be so noticeable. Now, Down here, I've got a different example. This is our Bright Eyes quilt, and this was featured in, let me see, issue 6 of our Modern Quilts Illustrated magazine. And the idea here was we were designing a baby quilt that would have the combination of bright colors and black and white. So if you've worked with batiks, you know where this could go wrong. Batiks and white, danger, right? Any bleeding is going to get into that white. So what we did is we first did pre-washing of the light colors with the Re-Tain to really make sure they were bonded. Then we did them again with Synthrapol to flush out any excess dye. Then we washed it. Oh no, sorry. Then we pieced it. And then when it was all done, we washed it one more time with the Synthrapol just in case anything bled again, which thank goodness it didn't. You know, it's hard to predict these things, but the one thing that you can predict is it's going to happen at some point. It just is. So generally pre-washing the way Weeks described yesterday is fine. That's usually adequate. But if you're dealing with something like a batik that has been immersed in a dye bath or a hand dye or a hand stamped fabric, you know, I was showing these. Some of these are from India and Indonesia, and again, the dyes may be what are called fugitive, they may escape, so we wanted to be super careful with those. Again, 5 minutes preparing the laundry, an hour in the wash, 5 more minutes ironing, it's all worth it. So enjoy your pre-washing as much as you can. Take care.